Good afternoon, it's Doc Stout, and I'm back again. Had some technical difficulties, and I can't exactly promise that they're over. If you're watching live, I have to warn you that the new version of my broadcasting software has done some funny things with my computer, mostly shutting them down unexpectedly. But until that happens, we are going to be taking a look at Dark Souls with a brand new character. I've tried this once before, but we're just going to jump straight into the action instead of going through the character creation process. This is a fresh character. We've got a slender Far East thief, starting, as always, in undead form. Locked in a cell with a busted sword and a corpse with a key on it. I am a very huge fan of this game. I have, with two characters now, made significant progress. One I've beaten the game with, and another I am attempting a soul level 1 run with. I have never tried Thief, though, so this will be something new. I have also named my character Zim, because while I prefer cooperative, jolly cooperation, I think that if this run is successful, I may actually try some PvP with this guy. So I will be an Invader Zim. Let's see. One of the things, besides the punishing difficulty that this game is known for, is asking interesting questions, like, what would happen in a world where no one ever permanently died? Most of the enemies, at least in the beginning parts of the game, are either demonic denizens of the fall of the world, or other people who are kind of like your character. They're undead, and they never permanently die. They reform after they've been killed by one thing or another. Eventually, they lose all hope and become hollow. And so those first couple of mindless zombies that we fought were other hollows. As the game progresses and you get into the lore, you learn a lot about what it means to be undead and what it means to be hollow or not. And how it affects different people. Get into this area here, and we see the first boss. We are not remotely ready to fight him with our busted sword, so we're just going to run over here. First time I played this game, I probably died 30-40 times before realizing that you could just avoid that first boss instead of hacking at him with a busted sword. Oh! And we've got an archer. We'll roll out of the way of his bullets. I selected something for my gift that I think I'm going to want to use now, in addition to getting a shield. I've already got it on. The Tiny Being's Ring. So that little bit of damage I took will slowly come back. And we'll lock onto this guy, so we'll automatically block those arrows. He's going to bug out. And we got a bandit's knife, which will be an upgrade from our broken sword. Sweet. Make sure I get out of the menu. And we can hear him just firing away at us. That's pretty sweet. Doesn't do much damage, but man is it fast. Got a fog gate here. Sometimes fog gates mark where bosses are. Sometimes they just show significant places that you have to get past, as in this case. We don't have a boss waiting. We are also approaching the spot I was at the last time I attempted this. The boulder trap that I didn't quite avoid this time either. But last time the stream ended with the bowler trap hitting me and the PC shutting down, so I think my new settings on OBS might be working out a little bit better for me. Since I'm low level, you'll see there's two bars. The top one is a health bar, and the bottom one is a stamina bar. Now, whenever I try to run, block, roll, or swing, the stamina bar goes down. As you level up, you use souls as the default currency for everything. They are your level up, they are your money, they level up your weapons, and whenever you die, you lose them all. To kind of save them, you can rest at bonfires, but when you do so, every bad guy that you've killed, aside from bosses, mini-bosses, and other special enemies, will respawn. So the archer I've already killed back. Mr. Boulder Rolling Guy up there's back. However, his boulder did knock out a wall.
Oh, you. You're now Hollow.
Nope, not Hollow.
I'm done for, I'm afraid.
This is the guy that dumped the body with the key into your cell at the beginning.
I wish to ask something of you. You and I, we're both undead. Hear me out, will you?
My apologies to anyone in chat right now, because I'm worried about CPU overheating and shutting down. I don't have chat up in another window at the moment.
Thou who art undead art chosen, and thine exodus from the undead asylum maketh pilgrimage to the land of ancient glory.
At first glance, this game doesn't have much of a story. When you start investigating the specific descriptions of all the items, and really examine the motivations of the various NPCs as you follow them around, the story kind of reveals itself to you. It just doesn't spoon-feed every little detail to you. Now I have the Estus Flask. It's a 5-use healing potion. And we've got a key.
I must bid farewell. I would hate to hurry you after death. So go now.
That 5-use healing potion, whenever you use one of those bonfires, you get your healing potion uses back. Alright. See if we can backstab. Nope. That's alright. Backstab is a special kind of attack. If you can get directly behind somebody, you do a special animation and a crazy amount of bonus damage. We'll practice that again up here. Oop, we got two guys. All of the enemies need to be observed. They have various attack patterns. Whoops! If you're fighting more than one, you should pay attention. I'm only locked on to one enemy, but the other guy is not going to let me go that easy. He's just going to keep swinging at me. Alright, so now I'm going to try to backstab this guy. Nope. Well, that's a skill I have to practice with this weapon. There's another special attack called parry, where you shield bash just as the opponent is about to attack you, and you can hit him back for a ton of damage. At this soul level, it's way dangerous to attempt a parry. Going for backstab seems to be a much safer option. Also, rolling or otherwise avoiding damage tends to not eat up any of your stamina and stamina bar, so it's always preferred to roll if you can. That one is locked, and I do not have the key, so I'm going to have to go back over to this fog gate. I'm going to take a hit off my Estus Flask first, and we will traverse the white light. Alrighty. Now we got the demon down there. What's up? Miss. That's terrible. Okay. What I was trying to do is a dropping attack. Since I missed, I'm going to have to do this the hard way, which will probably result in a you died. run for a few shots. Take a quick hit off the Estus Flask. Careful observation of enemy attack patterns. Oh! Unlike what I just did there, is always recommended. He's flying up and gonna plunge down. That probably would have been instant death if it had hit. Alright. Oh, you'll also notice that I am currently double-handing my weapon. I put my shield on my back. This guy hits hard enough that I'm not sure that trying to block his attacks is the smartest thing. So, I'm just gonna tank the couple hits I can't avoid. Heal through the ones I've had to take. Otherwise, try to roll. Roll. Okay. Frequently, you will take hits in this game if you get a little greedy and go for a second attack, the way I just did there. The other way is to mistime your rolls. Down to one shot on the Estus Flask. Alright, that was worth taking a couple extra hits for, I think. May be able to get Mr. Asylum Demon the hard way. Oh, yeah. Oh! Not helpful if you run out of stamina while you're comboing them. Whew! Alright. Victory achieved the hard way. Now that we've beaten the boss, we can save the game here. He will not respawn, but my Estus Flask uses well. And I've got a bunch of souls. I could use these souls right now to level myself up. Instead of doing that, we are going to switch back to shield mode and continue on. Now, despite the fact the demon's dead, you can still hear something big stomping around. What's cool is previously inaccessible areas of virtually every level can be returned to at later stages in the game. The same sort of tactics of observation and patience that you use in these fighting strategy can be used to access different areas of the level, of the various places you go.
You, give me warm, give me soft.
So this thing wants something soft and warm. I don't have anything soft and warm just yet. But that'll be important later. Alright, let's move out of this sort of undead asylum tutorial area and get a little cutscene.
Only in the ancient legends it is stated that one day an undead shall be chosen.
So, as the chosen undead, we're heading on to Lordran. When we get to Lordran, besides areas that are shut off by keys or switches or other things, other conditions needing to be met, the game doesn't stop you from going anywhere. You can go to an area that is appropriate to the gear and level that you've got, or you can go to some place that's much, much harder. Your progress is never permanently stopped in Dark Souls, but you can lose all the souls you've gained, so you're kind of gambling your progress if you don't use it. I'm not going to be attempting with the thief to go for a soul level 1 run, so we will probably use some of these souls here at this first bonfire. Let's talk to this guy first.
Well, what do we have here? You must be a new arrival. Let me guess. Fate of the undead, right? Well, you're not the first. But there's no salvation here. You'd have done better to rot in the undead.
You also, I believe, can attack any NPC.
Too late now. Well, since you're here,
I don't want to do that before he helps me out.
There are, actually, two bells of awakening. One's up above in the undead church. The other is far, far below.
So we're given some vague goals to go after.
Both, and something happened. Brilliant, right? Not much to go on. But I have a feeling that won't stop you. So, off you go. It is why you came.
So we need to ring two bells. This is a goal that will take many, many hours to complete. Not something we're going to be shooting for in this video. I would like, since we've escaped the undead asylum so far without crashing, to see if we can get maybe to the second boss. The Taurus Demon. That should be a decent goal for a first stream. After streaming this, I will probably hang out a little bit in case I've got anybody sitting in chat who is not able to talk to me. Answer some questions if anyone has any. Once I am certain that I can handle the PC issues without any crashes, I will probably more regularly participate in the chat. I'm also going to be hosting some cooperative streams. Oh, there we go. Successful backstab. With some of my buddies from a podcast that we're going to be launching in the next couple of weeks, called 40 Going on 14. So we're going to try and get some co-op games going with some of those guys. Okay, we're not going to follow him over the cliff. I'm actually not sure he went all the way down. Alright. No, he did not. Got another one of these night guys. Another backstab. Feel more thiefy already. That's totally a word. We've got a bloodstain there, and if you touch a bloodstain, you can see how somebody else died in this area. He was apparently drinking and jumped off a cliff. Alright. The multiplayer in this is interesting. Not only can you see phantoms from the way other people play these games, but if you are in human form, you can summon help, or you can be invaded by people intent on PvP. Summoning help is the more consensual, cooperative version of the multiplayer in this game, and PvP is not. It's not duels or going to a special PvP area. You can be invaded by someone whenever you're human. The question is, then, why would you ever want to be human instead of being all hollowed out and undead? Now, the simple answer to that is your item drop rate's a little higher, and you can only do certain things when you're in human form. You can only kindle your bonfires to give you 10 uses on your Estus flask instead of 5 when you're human. That's a significant benefit. But most of the time, if you are not prepared to do PvP, you should be, as I am now, all in hollowed out form. It's kind of hard to see my undead eyes since I'm in thief gear. Okay, shuck and jive on these guys. I am not intent on eating a fireball. Yep, but I did anyway. My intentions didn't matter so much. definitely a little bit more challenging to play the thief than some of the other characters. I've done Pyromancer, who is pretty much your only option for soul level 1 runs, and I have done a heavily armored knight. Got another fog gate here. Also, you can communicate between other players by spelling out phrases in these little runic messages using an item that we'll get later. Someone decided that they liked the view here. The messages might be funny, useless, helpful. That one says, be wary of left. It's a warning about the guy who came out of here. Or they may just lie to you, telling you to jump off a cliff and be safe and there's treasure down there. Those soul items allow you to get souls. You can see in the lower right-hand corner, we've got 3,028 souls at the moment. Which I should probably bank for leveling up soonish. Oh, I forgot about that drake. Not forgetting about stuff like that is definitely key to doing well in this game. The first time I played this, it was many, many hours before I got this far. Patience and observation will get you through. In general, the game is never cheap or unfair, but it also never lets up. If you make a mistake, you frequently will be killed. Bonfire. We can rest here. This is a pretty important bonfire, but I don't think I'm quite ready to kindle. Instead of leveling up, I'm going to go and do a few other things, because souls are also used as currency. Not too far from a shopkeeper at the moment. The one nice thing, if you do die, I've said you lose everything, but that's not quite true. You lose everything unless you can make it back to the spot where you died. And then all of the power that you have lost is just sitting there waiting to be reclaimed. You make a mistake, though, and then it's gone. And, of course, everything that you fought your way through does respawn. So you gotta get your way back to the point at which you died. You keep all of your items, though. It's souls and any active humanity that is up the numbers to the left of the health and stamina bar. Are the humanity. If you have a humanity, you can go to human form and kindle bonfires and do all that sort of fun stuff. Try parrying. That's pretty good advice. Let's do that. Let's try. Oh, I failed. It's good to try to practice, though. There we go. There's a successful parry. A successful parry, in addition to looking awesome, does even more damage than a backstab. And it is a tactic which I have never practiced nearly enough. Alright, well, we failed on that one, but something that, in order to progress, I should do better at. got our shopkeeper
well
buddy
now,
here.
You seem to have your wits about you. Hmm? Then you are a welcome customer. I trade for souls. Everything's for sale.
This guy also has an awesome weapon if you kill him. My first game, I accidentally killed him before getting the useful items off of him. So he sells the Guidance Soapstone to write messages to other players. Throwing knives, firebombs, talismans. I think what we really want, though... At the moment, I'm pretty happy with my inventory. So, question is, first do I grab the residence key, or first do I grab the repair box? I think the repair box is probably the right choice. And we will come back...
Thank you kindly.
...to get the residence key, which will open up some other areas. I also have the master key, which if you are not the thief, you have to choose as your opening gift. So I can use that to get through some shortcuts. I can't remember if this... Now, some of them are master key areas, some of them you just can open. Wooden shield. Might be better than what I'm using right now. Damage. Yeah, let's try equipping that. If it didn't slow me down any... Nah, looks pretty good. Alright, so now we got a bigger shield. I'm gonna go for the Taurus Demon. We've only got 829 souls. Let's level up just a little bit. It requires 741 to level up. And you can do an explanation for all the different stats. Endurance is definitely important, and it's a little low right now. So I think we're probably going to up our endurance with our level up. And now we're level 6. You start at different levels depending on your starting character class, and your initial equipment set's a little different. That first weapon you get, and the starting set of armor. Oh! Despite my additional stamina, I ran out and did not block that arrow. Loot that guy, that's a terrible shit. Whoa! Hello. Your movesets can combo you right off a cliff. Not something I'm eager to try. Stamina, so I kind of got staggered there when I tried to block. Maybe we'll try parrying this guy. Yeah. Sweet. Alrighty. Feeling pretty good about my progress so far. Ignoring his shield and hack, 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 hack. More terrible armor. Hey, buddy. Let's see. Every once in a while, these guys drop something good. Not very often, though. The archers are more likely to drop something good. I got some a firebomb there. Okay, we got a trio of guys here. Oh. Take a head off the old flask. I don't want to deal with those guys we saw chucking firebombs at us earlier, so I'm going to go after them now. And that's why you don't bring a firebomb to a knife fight. Okay, now I can lock on now that I'm not surrounded on all sides. Oh, looks like I got him. And I got a little bit of humanity, too. If you haven't beaten the area boss randomly after killing a bad guy, you might get a little bit of humanity. Well, that was in... Oops. Pro. Let's run up these stairs. What's up? And that guy's body gets stuck to my feet. And the thief's master key becomes useful. Access to a little treasure chest here. Some gold pine resin. I think that's plus electricity damage. Is actually, I think, the longest I've ever gone in this game without a "you died" message. Which I'm gonna screw it up now that I've pointed that out. Ah, crap, two of them. That's not what I want. Oh! That's what happens when you miss a parry. I like the thief. He's really fast. Come on, buddy. Oh. Oof. I may end up having to use the bonfire before the boss, which would respawn all these guys, which is not so good. Almost backstab. Is that a rolling trap up there? Yeah, it looks like it. Nope. Nope, 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 nope. We're not doing that. Most of these areas where I'm blithely avoiding and going straight to the guys, I learned a little bit at a time that the hard way where they are. Death after death after death. And we have a fog gate. Four hits on the Estus flask. Yeah, let's give this a shot. The fog gate is blocking our progress back, which usually is a sign that something bad is about to happen. Locked onto one guy and stabbing the other. Shot at the Taurus Demon. I think, one way or another, I am going to end this video with this attempt, successful or not. So let's wish me luck here. Okay, there's Mr. Taurus Demon. We are going to run like hell. That plunge attack that I failed to do on the Asylum Demon, we're going to give that a shot this time. Double-handed. Jump off. And missed. That's awesome. Took all sorts of damage from the fall and did none to the boss. Climb! Oh god, climb! Drink. Drink like your life depended on it. Oh god! Didn't know he could do that. Okay. So yeah, that's Dark Souls. Okay, we're back with 0 souls, 5 hits on the old Estus flask, and a bonfire. I'm gonna pick up with Zim here next time, but appreciate anyone who tuned in. I will be uploading this to YouTube in the next few hours, and I think this is going to be a semi-regular series. I'm going to take another shot next time at the Taurus Demon. Glad to actually complete a video without my PC powering down and be back. So I'm now confident that I can do regular streams, Magic Mondays on Monday. And in the next couple of weeks, you'll be able to see some of what I do with the guys in the podcast 40 going on 14. And as always, you can read what I write over at What's Next, The Unemployed Geek. My blog should be listed up on the Twitch channel and over on YouTube. So, I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in, and I will talk to you later. I see you in a